She's gone right in there. Let's see if I can get round and get a better view of her. Just trying to have a look at her. It looks as though there might be a gap from the other side. MKP, you're asking, is it possible that a leopard's coat has changed and evolved to blend in drier winter months than it is obviously during the summer? I'm not sure. Leopards, as far as we go back, pretty much have had the same golden colored coat, and it's probably because they occur in just so many different places, and that spotted patterned coat that you see, it blends in with a multitude of different environments. So you'll see it blending in mountainous areas, grassy areas like this, it blends in even desert places where there is very little grass. I'm just trying to see if I can get in here. So I think it's more a case that it's just about the fact that it blends in so many different ways, and it can kind of keep her from being seen, whether it's in grass like this or whether it's in open plains like in the deserts or anything like that. Actually, where there's really quite a nice view from here, so we'll have a good one. There we go, sensor, how's that? So that's better, now we can at least see. So I don't think it's evolved too much for the dry wintry period. Remember that this animal's still got to survive 6 months of the year where it's green and lush, and that's going to need some sort of camouflage as well. So you can't have a situation where an animal's evolved only for a certain period of the year and for when it's dry. It's got to be able to survive outside of that, and that means that this camouflage pattern has got to work in those times too, and it does. I mean, if you see when the grass is green, you would think this lighter color would really stand out, but it doesn't. Those darker spots then start to match the dark dappled light that we see in the summery time, because remember, all these trees will have leaves on them and there will be shade that is provided from all of that, and she'll still blend in incredibly well during the summer period. So the coat is more a fact that it needs to keep her alive all year round, not just from a dry point perspective, and when the color of the bush is this more yellowy color to match the kind of coats. So it just means that they were a little bit more successful in the winter months. But now she's going to stop and start grooming herself. So obviously this is where she's decided to settle for the day. She's going to end up with a situation where she'll groom, she'll clean, she's going to use that rough tongue to get rid of any little bits of meat or any sort of loose fur, anything that's got caught up in the toes when she's been hunting, and get herself in good condition, and then she'll probably fall asleep right here. It is close enough that she can see directly towards her kill and be able to see the meal, and if something goes in that direction that she can get to it. But it's a little further than I first thought. I thought she was going to lie down, you know, within 15 meters of it, but for some reason she's decided this is where she wants to sleep. She feels like to being underneath a tree and branch. Maybe there's less wind in there and it just feels a lot better to be hidden inside, but at least we've got a nice view of her now. It's much better than what we had earlier, so we will take this for now. And she, at the end of the day, is probably not going to move much more this morning. I highly doubt she's going to go from where she is now anywhere else and other than with her head down and sleeping, or not. Maybe she's now turned around and decided to just face us, which is really good. Now, Senzo's asking if I've got comms. Senzo, I don't at the moment, which is quite strange because everything seems to be in and working, so I'm not 100% sure why it's not working. So, Lou, if you can just speak to me and hopefully I can hear you. Ah, there we go. You're back. Welcome back, Lou. Nice to have you back in my ear again. It's always good when you have the voices in your head. So, there we go. Now, while Kuchava gets herself groomed and settled down for the morning, I'm pretty sure she is going to end up in a situation where she will sleep, but I believe James Hendry has a rather large big cat that, well, is doing the same thing and is having a little nap.